In this video, I will be reviewing the Mijia Cleaver from Xiaomi with a 9CR18 MOF core material. Hello guys, I'm Chef Panko and I used to work in a Japanese restaurant. Make sure to subscribe to know more about cooking and knives. Before we start with the review, I want to go over some disclosures. I bought this knife with my own money. No one sent them to me or paid me to use this knife or to make this video. If this video helps you in making a decision, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel a lot. Now with the disclosures away, let's start with the review about the Mijia Cleaver. Like most Xiaomi products outside of electronics, they name their kitchen appliances Mijia and choose a manufacturer to make a knife under their name. I found the manufacturer and got it confirmed that they were indeed making the knives for Mijia. The brand is called Dangjia, or also known as Dang, and they are a direct manufacturer. I will link their store in the description. The knife Rockwell hardness is specified with a Rockwell of 58-260, but it feels more like 58. Usually, you can get away with 3-4 months before needing a whetstone touch-up if you regularly hone your knife with a honing rod. However, the heavier cleaver-styled knife with a delicate thin edge and a low factory angle of 14 to 15 degrees has an impact on the knife edge retention. Therefore, the edge retention out of the box is closer to 2-3 months. In return, you get a sharper out of the box performance. You can easily add a new angle once the knife needs a whetstone maintenance. My advice is 20 degrees. The manufacturer Dangjia is making their knives with 3 different steel types. In short, they are reducing the manufacturing cost without sacrificing the quality. The 9CR18 MOF has excellent rust and corrosion resistant properties and the added cladding adds durability. It is inadvisable to slice through frozen food, bones, cheese, hard bread or force your way through other tough food like chocolate or crushed nuts, since that can cause chipping. Despite the 3 different steel, the knife itself is nicely welded together and you won't be able to tell the steel apart. The top part has a mirror finish and a different finish at the bottom so that food will stick less on your blade. If you look closely, you can even see the cladding line. The blade profile is what you would expect from a cleaver style knife. The blade has a gently curved belly in the middle. The knife weight is around 390 grams. The knife comes with a spine taper with 3.1 mm at the heel, 2.9 mm at the middle and 2.7 mm at the front. The knife is very stiff and there's no noticeable flex during use. The knife balance point of this knife is at the front. If you pinch grip at the blade or the curved cap, the knife will be front heavy, which you want for a cleaver style knife. The handle is made with red sandalwood with a hidden wired fill tang handle. It means that the handle is nicely secured in its place. The handle's curves are very comfortable and it won't be slippery since the wooden handle adds enough grip. They have added a rounded neck area so you can shift your gripping style without discomfort if you want more control and precise cutting work. The knife has a unique manufacturing process to reduce cost. Despite the unique manufacturing process, they did not reduce the quality. In fact, the fit and finish on this knife is very nicely done and the handle is from a good quality. They have thought about polishing the spine and the heel area so there are no sharp edges. Despite the questionable factory angle of around 14 to 15 degrees, the knife itself is from an excellent quality. Dangjia as a knife manufacturer has my recommendation. The weight of 390 grams is heavy on paper, but it feels lighter because of the excellent ergonomics from the handle and blade design. The profile tapering is also very nicely done and very thin. That's it for this video. If you have any questions or other opinions, leave them in the comment section below. If it helped you decide, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel a lot. If you want to know more about cooking and knives, please subscribe and hit the bell to get notified. Thank you for watching and I see you in the next video.